proud and so glorious, standing victorious, our souls will shine bright in the sky. When united we come to the land of the sun, with the heart of a dragon we ride. We are flying on wings in winter sky, with fire burning deep inside, with warriors of endless time, forever and on. On wings of steel in ancient flight, we see the powers that unite. The gods will now send us a sign of battles once more. Through the valley we ride, full of glory we soar, where the fights will be raging for now and evermore. When united we come, and divided they fall, tonight you will witness it all. Proud and so glorious, standing victorious, our souls will shine bright in the sky. When united we come to the land of the sun, with the heart of a dragon we ride. A land unknown, we've come so far. We ride the night till the morning star. When colors fade from black to white, your eyes come to sight. With a vision of the great divide, you turn towards the other side. You think you can run, but you can't hide. The dead cannot ride. Through the valley we ride, full of glory we soar, where the fights will be raging for now and evermore. When united we come, and divided they fall, tonight you will witness it all. Proud and so glorious, standing victorious, our souls will shine bright in the sky. When united you come to the land of the sun, with the heart of a dragon we ride. Over high seas and mountains, we fly to the heavens on wings of a dragon tonight. Proud and so glorious, standing victorious, our souls will shine bright in the sky. Proud and so glorious, standing victorious, our souls will shine bright in the sky. When united we come to the land of the sun with the heart of a dragon, the heart of a dragon, the heart of a dragon we ride.
To the break of dawn, yo!
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It's me, the Arbiter. Let's get the game started, shall we? I'm back with more Skyrim. So, I did a bit of off-camera work, reverted that work, because it taught me something. Meridia's beacon is stuck in the air, is in the area where we do the Dragonborn DLC. So what we're going to do is we're going to go do the Dragonborn side quest. As soon as we're going to advance the story, as soon as we do the first visits to the Greybeards, we're going to go do the Dragonborn DLC. And then as soon as we get the Dawnbreaker, we'll go and do the Dawnguard quest. So now we have a nice plan of attack for how we're going to handle this game. Let's travel to Whiterun real quick. Sell off the excess gear from fucking around inside this tower.
Disrespect the law, you disrespect me.
Understood. Now. Adriana? Actually, no. You know what? Let's go to the general store. Oh. Belthor is... Oh, it's only 6 a.m.? Well, there's a problem. Second of Heartfire. I wonder if that's the season?
Welcome to Belthor's General Goods. Welcome indeed.
How's it going, Belthor?
Everything's for sale, my friend. Everything. If I had a sister, I'd sell her in a second.
Let's trade.
Oh, a bit of this, a bit of that.
All right. Don't need those. Don't need those. Shield. Dented iron shield. We don't need that. That elven armor is pretty sick looking. I don't like the elves, but I can't deny that's a pretty good fit. Gold Imperial Officer's Cloak. Okay, we'll keep the gold ring. Don't need that or those. Frost resistance. That'll be good to break down for enchanting. We'll hold on to the silver sapphire necklace. And we'll weather reward circlet. That's not a circlet, good sir. That's a ring. Don't need the Warhammer, don't need the Greatsword. Bear Pelt, Clay, Soul Gem, Crundum, Firewood, Flawless Garnet, Glass, Glazed Bowl. Don't need the knife. Valuable painting. It's too bad I can't hang it in my house. That would be so cool to decorate my house with that. And with that, our carry weight is now down to 200. Oh, hi, Garlic. Nope, the cat has jumped into my lap. I miss having the little 8-bit cat visible in the TARDIS, Pando, the plugin. That way we could have the cat on stream.
Yeah?
You're dressed like a Dawnguard.
Need something?
Okay, I guess no special interaction for her. Actually, we can use the forge to smelt down what we're the ore we've made and we've got. Oh, I'm a moron! No! No! Oh, shit, I wasn't supposed to smelt that gold. Crap. Auto white run. Okay, good. The good news is that we did not lose much progress. Thank the Lord for autosave. I tell you, we'd be up Schitt's Creek if that didn't happen. Okay, Corundum. Now, we have three ore and it requires two, so I think we can make one. Well, that's weird. My phone just went into picture-in-picture mode for the Twitch. I wasn't trying to do that.
Something?
Alright, now we're gonna talk to the barkeeper at the tavern, so that way we can start the main quest. This is not the tavern. The Bannered Mare, there it is. Here, have a gold piece.
Oh, thank you. Divines, bless your kind heart.
Why are you begging?
It's what Brennan said I should do. He's the only one that's been nice to me since she died. My aunt and uncle took over our farm and threw me out. Said I wasn't good for anything.
That's horrible!
I wound up here, but I don't know what to do. I miss her so much.
I could adopt you if you want.
Really? Do you have a place I can live?
I do. I've got a nice new house.
Oh, wow. Are you sure? You really wouldn't mind?
I'm sure, daughter.
Yay! Thanks, Mr. Papa. I promise I'll be the best daughter ever.
All right, now let's observe her, because I don't want her to get stuck in the behavior loop like last time. She just stayed. She just like got stuck here in Whiterun, never left. Oh, I have a very bad feeling all of a sudden. Oh, wait, no, she's walking. All right, well, I think she headed back to the circular area, so as long as she doesn't do that, we should be fine. What's on the menu?
Depends. Are you thirsty? Hungry? Both.
Wow, they have a good stock of food. Let's grab some mead. And maybe some roasted goat.
Now please, no more questions.
If it's work you need, how about chopping up some wood for the fires? I enjoy this work well enough, but I'm ready to retire. I've been thinking of selling the inn to Isolde. Anyway, what do you need?
Have you heard any rumors lately? There have been rumors of suspicious activity around Helgen. Legion patrols have been spotted in the area. Then that's where I'm going next.
Just let me know. Oh, Sadie.
Yes, Mom.
I'll see you there, kid.
Let me guess. Someone stole us.
I do feel genuinely bad for her. Your aunt and uncle throw you out of the place that was passed down to you by your parents. That's just awful. That is vile behavior. All right, off to Helgen. Falkreath, Helgen. Let's travel to the Bannermist Tower, and we'll walk from there. Some nice chill woods. Honestly, I can kind of see why bandits would set up shop here. Listen to the Nirnroot singing. De Ruim Derienis. Alchemy increased to 11. I am 611 years old. I have never had children of my own, but I have many nieces and nephews and cousins who have been raised with the tales and traditions of our ancient, illustrious, and occasionally notorious clan, the Derieni. Few families in Tamriel can boast so many famous figures, wielding so much power over the fate of so many. Our warriors and kings are stuff of legend. And it is not to dismiss their honor and their achievements to say that you have heard quite enough about them. I myself have never picked up a sword or written an important law, but I am part of a lesser known but still important Derieni tradition, the Way of the Wizard. My own autobiography would be of little interest to posterity, though my nephew, nieces, and cousins indulge me to tell wild tales of life in the chaotic second era of Tamriel. But I have few ancestors whose stories should be told. They may have changed history as we know it as dramatically as my better known relatives, but their names are in danger of being forgotten. Most recently, Lysandus, the king of Daggerfall, was able to conquer his ancient enemies of Sentinel in part thanks to his court sorceress, Medora Derieni. Her grandfather, Yovron Derieni, was an imperial battle mage to the court of the Dunmer Empress of Tamriel. Kataria, assisting her in creating a peace in a time of turmoil, his great-great-grandfather, Peladil Derieni, had a similar role with the first Potentate, and encouraged the Guild Act without which we would not have all the professional organizations we have today. His ancestor many times back was the Witch Raven Derieni, who with her better-known cousins, Aiden and Rhaen, brought an end to the tyranny of the latter Eliasin Empire, before the Decigics of Artium. It is said she created the art of enchanting, learning how to bind a soul into a gem, and use that to ensorcel. Ensorcel? All manners of weaponry. But it is the story of an ancestor even more ancient, more distant than Raven, I wish to tell. Asliel Darieni harkens back to the humble beginnings of our clan in the tiny farming village of Tariel on the banks of the river Kaumas, which was then called the Darieni. Hence the family name, like all on the Somerset Isles. In those days, he was a simple planter of the fields. But while others only grew enough to sustain their immediate kin, even distant cousins of the Darienis worked together. They would decide as a group which fields were best for wheat, orchard, vine, livestock, or apiary, and thereby always have the best yields of any farm which worked alone, doing the best as it could with what it had. Asiel had a particularly poor for most kind of agriculture, but small herbs found its stony loaminess, acidic soil, very comfortable. Out of the necessity more than anything else, he became an expert on all manners of herbs. For the most part, of course, they were used in flavoring cooking. But as you know, hardly any plant grows on the surface of our world without a magical potential. Even so long ago, witches already were in existence. It would be ridiculous for me to suggest that Asliel Darieni invented alchemy. What he did, what we can all be grateful for, is that he formulated it into an art and science. There were no witches, covens in Tyregrail, and of course there would be no mages' guild yet for thousands of years. So people would come to him for cures. He learned for himself the exact formula for combining black lichen and rubush to create a cure for all manners of poisons. The amount of willow another to crush and mix with chokeweed to cure diseases. There were few much greater threats in Tyrigil than in those peaceful days than disease or accidental poisonings. Yes, there were some dark forces in the wilderness, trolls, chimera, the occasional malevolent fairy and folk, and will-o'-wisp, but even the youngest, most foolish Altmer knew how to avoid them. There were, however, a few unusual threats which Asliel had a hand in defeating. One of the tales of old told of him that I believe to be true is how he was brought a young niece who had been suffering from an unknown disease. Despite his ministrations, she grew weaker and weaker every morning. Finally, he gave her a bitter-tasting drink, and the next morning, ashes were found all around her bed. A vampire had been feeding on the poor girl, but Asliel's poison had turned her very blood into poison without harming her in the least. If only this formula had not been lost in the mist of history, this world would have been enough to make him a minor but significant figure in the annals of early Somerset. But at that point in history, a barbarian tribe called the Lokvar had found their way down the Darren River and recognized Tergil as a rich target for raids. The Darieni, not being warriors yet, but simple farmers, were helpless and could only flee and watch. The Lokvar take the best of their crops raid after raid. Asliel, however, had been experimenting with the vampire dust and brought his cousins to him with a plan. The next time the Lokvar were sighted on the Darien, the word went out, and all the most able-bodied came to Asliel's laboratory. When the barbarians arrived in Tergil, they found the farms deserted and assumed that all had fled as usual. As they set about stealing the bounty, they suddenly found themselves under attack by invisible forces. Believing the Darieni farms to be haunted, they ran away very quickly. They attempted a few more raids, for their greed would always eventually overpower their fear, and each time they were set upon by attackers who they could not see. As barbaric as they were not stupid, and they changed their mind about the source of their defeat. It could not be that the farms were haunted, because the crops were still being tended and harvested, and the animals seemed to show no fear. The Lokvar decided to send a scout to the farm to see if he could spy their secrets. The scout sent word back to Lokvar that the Dariani farms were populated with flesh and blood and entirely visible. Altmar. He continued to watch as his barbarian cohorts moved down the river, and he saw the elderly children flee for the hills, while the able-bodied farmers and their wives went to Aziel's laboratory. As he saw them go in, he saw no one come out. As usual, the Lokvar were repelled by invisible forces. But their scout soon told them what he saw happening in the laboratory. The next night, two of the Lokvar approached Alseel's farm very stealthily and managed to kidnap him without alerting the rest of the Dariani. The Lokvar chieftain, knowing that the farmers could no longer count on the alchemist to make them invisible, considered an immediate attack on the farms. But he was a vengeful sort, and felt he had been humiliated by these simple farmers. A crafty plan emerged in his mind. What if the Dariani, who always saw his barbarian tribe coming, for once did not? Imagine the slaughter if no one had the chance to flee. The scout had told the chieftain that Aziel had used the dust of a vampire to make the farmers invisible. But he was not sure what other ingredients had been... He described an incandescent powder that Aziel had mixed into the dust. Alseal of the Chorus refused to help the Lokvar, but they were experts in torture as well as pillage, and he knew he would have to talk or die. Finally, after hours of torture, he agreed to tell them what the incandescent powder was. He did not know the name, but he called it Glow Dust. The only remains of a slain will-o'-the-wisp, he told them they would need a lot of it if they wanted to turn the whole tribe invisible for the raid. The Lokvar grumbled that not only did they have to find and kill a vampire to attain his dust, but find and kill several will-o'-wisps to get theirs. In a few days' time, they came back with the ingredients for the alchemist. The chieftain, not being a complete idiot, made Aziel taste the potion first. He did as he was told and turned invisible. Demonstrating that it did truly work, the chieftain put him to work creating more. No one apparently noticed that while he was nibbling on black lichen and rue brush. The Lokvar took the potion as he doled it out, and as soon, but did not too soon, they didn't suffer. They were all dead. The scout who had seen Alseal mixing the invisibility potion had apparently mistook the glow of the candlelight in the laboratory for an incandescence, which the second ingredient of the invisibility potion did not possess. The second ingredient was actually dull simple redwort, one of the most common herbs in Tamriel. When they had insisted during torture that Alseal tell them what the incandescent powder was, Alseal remembered that he had once experimentally mixed glow dust and vampire dust together once and created a powerful poison. It was simple enough to steal a little redwort from the barbarian's camp, mix that with the vampire and glow dust mixture to create a potion that was, in fact, an invisibility potion. After curing himself, he gave the poison to the barbarians. The Lokvar, being dead, never again raided the Dariani's farms, and having no other enemies, they were able to grow more and more prosperous and powerful. Generations later, they left Somerset and began their historic adventures on the Tamriel mainland. Alseal Dariani, because of his excellence as an alchemist, was invited to Arteum and became Dysilogic, I believe. It's not known how many more of the common formulas we know today were invented by him there, but I have no doubt the science and art of alchemy as we know it today would not exist without him. But that is all in the distant past. Alseal's innovations, like my modest ones, like the achievements of the Darianis throughout history, are but a stepping stone to the wonders which will come in the future. I wish I could be there to witness them. But if I can only share some of the past with the children of Dariani and the children of Tamriel, then I will consider my life well spent. That was an interesting read. What do we have over here? Evergreen Grove discovered. An alchemist. I wonder what he was doing out here. King of Worms. Alchemy increased to 12. What? Who's attacking me? Oh, it's a Spriggan. I hate these guys. Okay, the fact that you can do that is kind of a bitch. Oh my lord! Okay, we're investing in health. Damn fairies. At least I think the Spriggans are fairies of some sort. Alright, we should keep walking. Last thing we need is get dropped by an- dropped on by another set of Spriggans or some other wildlife. Oh, I see Falkreaths nearby. What was that? You guys hear that? Necromancers. It just isn't a day for a paladin if you don't slay some necromancers. The day's just not complete without that.
A new
what?
Touches the beacon.
Oh! Wow, okay!
Listen. Hear me and obey. A foul darkness has seeped into my temple. A darkness that you will destroy.
Yes!
Return my beacon to Mount Kilcreath. And I will make you the instrument of my cleansing light.
I mean, I am a paladin. This is what I do. I am a cleansing light unto the world. Liminal bridges. What, we going into the back rooms? Transitional passages of quickened objects or entities without the persistent agency of hyperagonal media is not possible, and even if possible, would result in instantaneous retromission of the transported reference. Only a transpontine circumpenetration of the limen will result in the transits of greater than infinitesimal duration. Okay, yeah, this is big brain time. I'm taking it with me. The Book of Daedra. Azura, whose sphere is dusk and dawn, the magic in between realms of twilight known as Moonshadow, Mother of the Rose, and Queen of the Night Sky. Let's read up on Meridia. Meridia, whose sphere is obscured to mortals, who is associated with the energies of living things. Wow, Molag Bal, whose sphere is domination and enslavement of mortals, whose desire is to harvest the souls of mortals and bring mortal souls within his sway by spreading seeds of strife and discord in mortal realms. I'm 99% sure that Molag Bal is supposed to be a is supposed to be a hybrid of Molak and Bal. Those are some scary motherfuckers. All right. We'll travel to Dragon Bridge. And then we'll head to Meridia's Beacon.
Get mad, and I'll prank you. Not a little, but a lot.
Favorite with Stendar, 92%. All right, better quick save. If we run into those vampires again, I don't want to get the plague from them. I'll get the vampire AIDS. And that's the last thing we need.
How can I assist?
Sick armor, bro. Okay, we got a Legion patrol instead of vampire vigilance.
He's always looking for strong people, warriors. It takes. Keep an eye out for trouble. It's only a matter of time.
Oh, you are Altmari, a Thalmor at that.
Make it quick.
Oh, I will. Your death will be quick, but very, very painful.
No! Don't do that.
Look at my temple lying in ruins. So much for the constancy of mortals, their crafts and their hearts.
Fucking Thalmor.
They love me not. How can my love reach them?
I mean, you do come across as kind of imposing, Meridia. I'm just saying, you get more flies with honey than vinegar.
I might guide you toward your destiny.
Woo! We're way up high now.
It is time for my splendor to return to Skyrim. But the token of my truth lies buried in the ruins of my once great temple, now tainted by a profane document skittering within. The necromancer Malkarin defiles my shrine with vile corruptions, trapping lost souls left in the wake of this war to do his bidding. Worse still, he uses the power stored within my own token to fuel his foul deeds. I have brought you here, mortal, to be my champion. You will enter my temple, retrieve my artifact, and destroy the defiler.
I mean, Stendar got here first, Meridia, but I will absolutely do this for you.
Mortals call it dawnbreak.
Tell me about this sword.
In a holy light that breaks upon my foes, burning away corruption and false life. You will enter my shrine, destroy Malkarin, and retrieve this mighty blade.
I'll do it.
Of course you will. I have commanded it. Go now. The artifact must be reclaimed, and Malkarin destroyed. Malkarin has forced the door shut, but this is my temple, and it responds to my decree. Send down a ray of light. Guide this light through my temple and its doors will open.
Oh, she's putting us down now. No. Alright. Oh wait, I think I'm supposed to interact with that light pillar first. Okay, the entrance to the temple ought to be around here. Yeah, here we go. Oh man, the air in here is vile. Empty. Some gold. No door can stop me. Ancient Nord honed sword. Where do we go from here? Favor with Stendar 92%. Okay. Oh, I'm dumb. How did I miss that hallway? Like, seriously. I'm suspicious that we haven't encountered anything undead yet. Aedra and Daedra, I already have a copy of that at home. I'll take the armor, though. And the Cloak of Meridia. Ah, here we are. Wraiths. Imperial sword and a northern axe. Good thing my sword works on the incorporeal. Then again, this is the blade of a paladin, so I wouldn't expect anything less. I'll take that silver candlestick. That looks fucking sweet. What's our carry weight at? 333 out of 395. Okay, so we can't go through this doorway. But I'd be willing to put money on the fact that we are supposed to progress through this way. You are nothing! Oh! Alright, I'm back. I had to step out for a bit to grab some soup. Oh, right. There, now I can see the chat again. I'm a bit turned around. I think this is the way we came in from? No, no it's not. Wait, yes it is. There's all these gold in these urns. Aha! Ah! That was a well-timed block. Activate this, it opens the way for us. Cool. Is that a giant egg? Or an egg shell? More likely some piece of pottery. Let's learn the enchantments. Thalmordum robes. Destruction spells cost 10% less. I think these Thalmor robes look pretty fucking sweet, but I'm gonna get rid of them. Okay, who's taking pot shots at me? Nope. That broke that. Oh. There we go. I wonder what that unlocked. I think maybe that, oh wait, duh, it unlocked this. Wait, this leads to the Killcreath balcony. So that's not the right way. Potato soup. Good shit. Excuse me, I had a little bit stuck in my throat. What happened? Oh. Okay. Well, we're having some good finds, at least. It's not immediately clear how we're supposed to get into this room. Or what I'm supposed to be doing, for that matter. Supposed to go. I remember having trouble with this quest too when I first attempted to do a Let's Play of this game. That connects to that. Well, that's the Killcrease balcony. Well, let's double back. Maybe if we get, maybe if we go back the way we came, we'll find another route to go. Yeah, see? This big door's open now. Oh, wait a minute. It already was, wasn't it? Okay, no matter. Is there a passageway I have not walked? I'm gonna take a bite of my soup and think this one out. Perhaps if we walk around on the balcony, we'll find another entrance. Too bad Ellie's not here. She probably would know where I'm supposed to go. She's played this game a lot. Okay. You'd think it'd be impossible to get lost in a linear-ass dungeon like this one. I guess that just goes to show how bad my sense of direction is. Yeah, this leads to the Killcrease balcony. Thank you. that opened this door. So our next part, so I guess we do have to walk through the Killcreath balcony. Oh, big chest. Whoops. Oh, we were close with that one. Nope. There we go. And just like that, I'm over encumbered. Outstanding. Killcreath Ruins. I'm just gonna operate under the assumption that we're on the right track. Wait, that's empty? Okay, yeah, no, this is definitely different. Oh, would you look at that? More shades. Oh, cool. Blocks leveling up. And being encumbered fucking sucks. Now, wait, I'm in combat right now? Oh, I see. Now, how do I get up there? Is the real question. There's gotta be a way. You know, a random thought just popped into my head. Some people find children's nursery rhymes creepy, like Ring Around the Rosie. And I, for a while, I didn't get that. But, some Halloweens back, I decided for, like, nostalgia's sake to listen to Five Little Pumpkins Sitting on a Gate. And I don't know why, but that has, like, a really eerie vibe to it. It's, like, unsettling almost. Like, Ring Around the Rosie? Nah, miss me with that. That's not scary. That one feels like it's trying too hard, honestly. Five Little Pumpkins, though, yeah, that one might fuck with me. Okay, how the fuck do I get up there? Because it looks like we had a bridge at one point, and it's not there anymore. Wait, okay. How long has this been here? Am I just an idiot? I guess yes. I'm hitting the button on this one as soon as I finish the shade. Yeah, here we go. Yeah, evidently I'm an idiot. How much gold do I have? 23,000. Okay, it's getting to the point where we might not be where we might not pick up everything that's dropped by every bandit we fight. Nope, that one's empty. But that one isn't. I'll take these linen wraps. I think they can be useful for crafting. I don't immediately know what they're good for, though. Dwarven sword. This is actually what Joyous probably looked like. For those of you who don't know, Joyous was the sword of the French King Charlemagne. It was an eye sword made of solid gold. Very ceremonial. I can't imagine trying to actually slay motherfuckers with that kind of drip. Gold doesn't make for a very effective weapon. Bends and breaks too easily. Oh, fuck me. Alright, I'm gonna quick save because I don't want to have to trudge my way back up here. Oh wow, it worked. Sweet. Ancient scalpel, corpse. The corpses have decent gold on them. Battle of Red Mountain, block increased to 36. We'll read this at a later date. There we go. Actually, what's the Nordic Bull really look like? Nah. Carry weight 500 something. I believe we're getting very close to the Necromancer's lair. Best me. You're cannon fodder. You're undead cannon fodder. You are the cheapest unit available. Meanwhile, I'm a legendary motherfucker. Ah. Maybe I should watch some more Chainsaw Man later tonight. I haven't watched it since hanging out with my friend Jay, and it was a good anime. I should watch more of it. Oh, I see. That happens whenever I get hit and walk through the beam. Alright, hopefully we can win this fight. Just take a bite of soup for good luck. I absolutely love potato soup. Why does this place even have catacombs? If Meridia is this Daedric princess of light and life, why would she have catacombs? Actually, I take that back. That's a dumb question. Christian churches have had a history of having, like, graveyards, so, yeah. Question withdrawn. That was dumb. Seriously? We gotta be getting close by now. Oh, hold up. Looks like we got a potion over here. And a chest. Wow, okay. Hopefully we'll make short work of the necromancer in here. Then again, he is being powered by a Daedric artifact. Alright, your unholy black magic ends here. Destruction increased to 9. Oh my lord, we got beaten. We got beaten hard. Excuse me for a second, I'm gonna finish the soup. Some of the bosses in this game are kind of a bitch. Bro! What the fuck? Cool it! That's a pun, I'm sorry. Okay, items. Oh, baby, did you see that?
It is done. The Defiler is defeated. Take Dawnbreaker from its pedestal.
I reflected the spell back at him. Man, it bumped up my destruction skill significantly too. Holy crap. Wow, it really bumped up my destruction skill. And now for the prize we came here for. You are my prize. One-handed. Keep the sword, but find someone else to spread your religion.
It matters not. The plant cares nothing for the rays that bring it the warmth of the sun. As you carry Dawnbreaker, so will my light touch the world.
All right. Yeah! Krisimir, you've been a good blade, but the time has come. Into Magicka. Destruction, dual casting, impact, augmented flames, frost, shock, rune master. Crackling Sphere, Hellstorm, deals 50% more to elemental damage to targets that are ignited, frozen, or levitated by other destruction spells. How's our restoration looking? Vigilant Ward requires 70, okay. Inner Light, 60, 80. Enchanting. Power Stone. Stabs. Oh, I don't use stabs, so that's a no. Block is at 36. That requires 40. Elemental Protection. How's this one looking? 60, so in 3 levels. Crater Maker as well. lockpicking still needs work. Speech 52. 37 out of 50. We might put in, we might start putting into alchemy. All right, let's toggle Todd mode and fast travel to a place where we can sell off the extra crap we're carrying. I should check on the Hall of the Vigilant. I'm worried that the place was destroyed by vampires. Oh, and we do have Helgen. We have Dawnbreaker. We have the, fuck. The Dawn Guard DLC to do as well. Let's travel to Whiterun. Oh, this bug, huh? Okay. I remember there's a, we're just gonna save and quit real quick. System save. That's usually how I fix this bug.